Are you ready to open her up? Oh, it even sounds horrible. Oh, that's a pungent whip.
Drink some of the juice and figure the video should get banned.
The window's been fine. The window has not been any trouble for almost a freaking year now. Keep that in mind. About to go into the parking space. It goes halfway up, then jams and goes all the way down. And it sounded like the glass fell. And I was like... Stuff happens to me. Oh my god, I almost just dropped my camera. Better be my kettles. I've just done a facial, okay? I've had some flare-ups around all parts of my face and I do not want to talk about it right now. Do you remember? I think it was Serene's Mendy, I think it was. Yes, it was. And it was one of the most ridiculous nights ever. Amazing, but one of the most ridiculous nights. So we all remember how the left passenger window decided to, you know, go down after I pressed the button and just locked itself wide open during a storm, all dolled up when the wind was blowing, the rain was falling, and I had my full camise, I was full face, everything. So that happened. Repaired it. I have been spending a lot of money on my girl being fixed at the moment. I moved my car because I work in a place where the council are absolute assholes. They won't even let the employees that work there have permits for their car. So what they like to do is only give like 12 parking spaces at the back of the strip of all these places that we work, which isn't enough because there's at least like 50 odd people that work in all these places on this strip of road, which is freaking ridiculous. So the only way you can get out of this is park on the street, where most of the time there's a parking warden that is ready at the go to give you a big fat ass yellow plastic bag. So we have to move our car after 3 hours of being in the main car park. So it was my turn to move my car and I was swapping with my colleague. Everything was fine, but it was bloody hot the other day, right? And when you go in my car, I haven't got air conditioning in my car, which was a really bad idea. I should have got it done. I didn't think at the time. It was so hot in there, I actually was in a panic and I literally rolled both the windows down. The window's been fine. The window has not been any trouble for almost a freaking year now. Keep that in mind. About to go into the parking space. It goes halfway up, then jams and goes all the way down and it sounded like the glass fell. And I was like... Woosa. Stuff happens to me. I thought, I can't leave the car on its own. The window's wide open and it's out there. The car's out there. And I'm thinking, holy crap, what am I going to do? So I call my work. My manager, she answers. And I'm like, I'm going to call her Anna. I'm like, Anna, girl, I don't know what to do. My car is open. The window is open. And she's like, we'll close it then. I'm like, that's the thing. I can't. And she was like, oh, have you thought about maybe bringing your dad over? And I'm freaking out because I said, look, I don't know what to do, whether to take the car home. It was bad. So finally, luckily, when we did some clearing out in Manal's house the other day, house. I'm very tired. I've done a lot of stuff today. I find this like load of like under carpet stuff, right? So I've jammed it into the door and somehow locked it all together, basically. There was no way you could get in my car. So we'll leave that for now. I call my mum and I'm like... It's happened again. And mum's like, not again. And it just happens at the most worst of times. It doesn't happen outside my driveway. It doesn't happen when I'm cleaning the car and I'm opening the windows. It doesn't happen when, like, I'm going to a friend's house. No. It happens while I'm at work and I have to park it round the back alleyway with the bloody window open. We've, like, done a thing where, like, we've put, like, a safety thing at the bottom so the window can't... It's locked up at the top, but they've put... loads of stuff at the bottom so in case the glass falls down it's not going to smash, because then that's like a couple of hundred quid out the window. I don't even want to jinx her right now. We've done a thing where like it's completely sealed that it can't be opened yet, and there's a lot of work going on the door. There's a kit coming and they're going to fix the whole entire thing, and it's not as pricey as I thought it was going to be, so I was very, very relieved about that. I couldn't go into it yesterday, but anyway, my ear was so bad yesterday morning. I think it's where I washed my hair the night before. Sometimes with my ear, like, if you don't know, I've got ear problems. But this side, I think, like, even if the most tiniest bit of shampoo goes in your ear canal, game over. It's, no, I'm in agony. On my work rota, it was supposed to be 8 till 12. I get to my work at 10 to 8. My manager, I'm going to call him John. I'm going to call him John. And he's like looking at me like I'm crazy. He's like, what are you doing here, girl? I'm working here today. And he was like, I don't think you're supposed to be here till 9. So then I'm like, kind of low-key fuming about that. Like, he thought it was funny. And I said, you know what else is really funny? So I showed him the picture of the state of inside my car because all the, like, the door interior is completely out. Like, they're fixing this window. And he's cracking up. And he said, only you this happens to. I'm like, yeah. It was just a really hectic day. It was a really hectic morning. A Fanta exploded, literally, all over me. Like, on the first hour of my shift. Like, out of nowhere, I get this crazy guy shouting. I'm not going to go into that because it makes me angry. He shouts to multiple people at my work. He rarely comes, but you just look at him and you think, oh, damn. Why the hell do women raise men like that to think that screaming at women like that is okay? I get out of work and then one thing happened after another. My thumbnail went wrong for today's video. The video didn't come out on time. Just everything. It was all going wrong. So anyway, I'm going to have a chilled one tonight. Anyway, so let's chill out.
Guys, please tell me to get the vegetarian sushi. Please. Yes. I want some mixed fruits for lunch tomorrow. These look nice.
Or do we go with this? Because it's 30% off.
Very handy.
This is actually really decent. $1.49.
The great value pack.
Well, I've got quite a few at home already.
Do you need hummus? Normal hummus. That's not like been mashed into. What did the hummus do to you?
Lovely. I'll show you guys what I got when I get home. I go there like half an hour before it closes. It's not that much stuff there, but like you just buy the stuff that you need. You're getting these wankers that are coming in like 2 minutes till closing time with trolleys. Just, I know how they feel because I work in retail myself. Some people suss me out in there. It's my local Aldi. Anyhows, I just got some little bits and bobs that I actually needed, like fruit, bit of veg, bit of tofu. We just gotta go to the shop, see if we got any like reduced things like fruit, veg, or anything that like, you know, veggie meat or anything always goes on reduce on a Friday night, later night, where I would be clubbing right now, but no, I go food shopping when it's quiet. There was just no veg to be seen. So I've just filmed a huge Temu haul. So I'm doing some bits that I've bought in here. Some of these bits are for like to try some of the things. I can't wait. It'll be on Wednesday coming as you guys are watching it. So the Temu, I am very excited to put this up because I haven't seen many Temu haul videos out. I just saw it and I was really intrigued by it. Well, wasn't intrigued in it in the first place. It just kept spamming me with ads with Temu. So by the looks of it, the look of the website, it's like a refurbished version of Wish. But I know they've refurbished Wish. So I've barely got that much makeup on and my hair looks like a mess because I've got medicine on my scalp because it's got really, really bad again. I woke up this morning and, you know, I've just had a couple of crazy days at work. I had a couple of emotional breakdowns, as I always do. Not funs at all. Wow, that moon's beautiful. Wow. This is why I love living here. I see the mist going over the moon. How, like, living here, these are like these sorts of things where you go, wow, I'm blessed to live here. I used to always dream of living in the sea, but now as I've got older, like, I just know now how blessed I am to be living in this sort of area. Actually, that's a dream of mine, to go and see the Northern Lights. But the only thing is though, with my luck and my karma, and my luck goes in threes, full well, I'll probably get like 3,000 return flight to go and see it, and it won't happen. And then probably the day I come home, it will happen. Oh, this guy's going really fast behind me. I don't really like it. I hate it when it goes so up your bum and you think, there's a camera right there, and you think, slow the hell down.
So, I got some of these from this app. From Aldi, I got chicken seasoning. And then from Tesco's, we got rice crackers.
Guys, I just bought this. It's fruit fusions from Aldi, and it's in a strawberry and watermelon. A little goes a long way. It's very strong indeed.
What else did I buy?
Got a couple of veggie sushis, hummus, bits of fruit. Got some corn meat that was on reduced. Then we got some tofu. It's there somewhere. Got some cut fruit there and some tofu, and that's that.
Okay guys, I'm not naked, just got one of these on again. I've literally got 5 of these from boohoo.com and they never sold them again, and now I'm devastated. We're gonna take this slap off. We're gonna take a slap off with the Jeffree Star Make Me Melt Makeup Removing Balm. This stuff is unbelievable. I've been trying to get the cleanser, toner and moisturizer again, but it's sold out on Beauty Bay, and it's the only place I can get it at a decent price. So, womp womp for me. Look at that. A little goes a long way. I've had this for 5 months, maybe? Yeah, about 5 months. Just over 5 months, I think. So, that is quite decent for that much. A little goes a long way. I'm going to do a mask and all that malarkey today. We're just going to have a nice, clean. Jeffree Star stuff keeps selling out. So, I was, like, doomed for a little while. I just couldn't find skincare that, like, I'm like, oh, wow, that works for me. I found this brand, and it's in Home Bargains at the moment. Oh, bloody hell. It's in Home Bargains at the moment, and I'm really impressed. It's normally, like, £26 a bottle, but now it's, like, £3 in Home Bargains. My skin's quite dry, so I want to make sure all of the makeup is completely gone. And we'll be having a nice, lovely waking up bath in the morning. I love to do baths in the morning. I'm not really a bath time in the night. Unless it's like an equinox or something. I am not really into having baths in the night, which is weird. Because a lot of people do find that weird. Everyone goes, I love a shower in the morning. I'm not really into showers anymore. Unless I have to. This mascara from Jeffree Star is amazing. Like, it does not come off at all. Does not move. It stays. My eyebrows are gone. I wish I could use whites. I'm allergic to them. I leave like a warm flannel on there for a few seconds. Just let it do what it's got to do. How's your day doing? Mine went great. I got a lot of crap done. So I just like pull it downwards. Ugh. Oh, yuck. Like my scalp has been bad. I've got medicine on my scalp now as we speak. And it is so bad. Like it does bring me down. Like a lot of people ask me, I say, does it make you feel down? And of course it makes me feel down sometimes. You've got to take what you're given and roll with it. So a lot of people ask me, what is it that I have? It's like a psoriasis, but on steroids. It's really unpredictable. Like, I'll have this for a couple of years and a couple of years it's gone. But mind you, I've seen one girl online. I think she's on Instagram. And she says she stopped using her birth control. And it just went away. And like, it comes to show you, like, the most randomest things can trigger any skin problem. And then I get really frustrated when people go to me, oh, you're eating dairy. Do you think I'd still be eating dairy if I knew that's what was causing it? With me, if I get upset or stressed about something, that's when it gets really bad. It's all over my butt cheeks at the moment. I don't even know why it's there, but it's there. Feeling cleaner already. So I'm not going to scrub because I scrubbed this morning. We're going to go with the Face Fact Ceramide Skin Barrier Complex. Yeah, you've seen me use this 100 times. It's cheap as chips, this brand, Face Fact. But this is really nice. Really nice and foamy as well. Look at that. Lovely. They're going to take all the nasties away. So I do this morning and night because it's just a gentle one. But then every couple of days, I use my St. Ives scrub because I can't find like a nice thin micro bead kind of facial scrub at the moment. It doesn't really upset my skin. Or don't it feel good though after you've done your cleansing tone and your skin's breathing again? Oh, it just feels so good. I have been meaning to start bringing toner with me to work and a couple of cotton pads. Do it a couple of times a day because I think air conditioning in shops really makes my skin oily. I know it sounds dumb, but I don't know if it does, but that's my reason. If I go somewhere that's got a lot of air vents in it, my skin gets really oily. If I'm there for a long amount of time, oh, don't you just love that when your skin starts to breathe? Okay, so toner. We bought this last week. You guys came with me last week. This stuff I bought for £1 in B&M. It's the best one I've ever used, to be honest with you. This is the XBC Tea Tree Facial Toner to soothe, calm, and cleanse your skin for a healthy glow. So this was literally £1. Ooh. Next time I've got a day off, I'm really gonna attempt to go there again and get a few more bottles of these because this stuff is really good. I only normally use toners really, like during the spring, summertime. I'm just gonna get a cotton pad. Normally I use a flannel, but mum's been complaining about how many flannels I've been using. And she's been saying, do you know what the neighbors think of us when we got all those flannels on the washing line? Yeah. Nothing. Oh, so good. Oh my goodness. So the flare up was here. It swells and then it dries up, then it breaks away. We're gonna go with the Selfless by Hyrum Mandelic Acid. The gentle exfoliating serum. So you do this every other day. It's in this very weird little bowl, and I like it because it shows the moon and the sun, like with to do with it's day or night. But they said a little goes a long way. I'm gonna buy more of these because this stuff is amazing. The moisturizer too. You can just work it in and it's lovely. This stuff has really calmed my skin down. It sinks in super quick. I do look a bit red, but this is where my flare-ups were. And it was just like so bad. I had a day off on Sunday last weekend, and literally as well my ear played up and everything like that. Could be a reason why I flared up and all that sorts of thing. A couple days before that, I literally had a meltdown. I bottle a lot of things up, and then when it comes out, it's like that, the big eye green monster. Like, just literally, I turned into the exorcist. It was awful. My man probably thought, Jesus Christ. Take her to the convent. Then the next morning, it was all red, and I was like, oh. Why do I do this to myself? It's when I'm stressed. And I hate it when you get like some people turn around and go, was it because you're fat? And I'm like, no, I've had this since I was like weeks old. Oh, it's the most annoying thing. So I go through years when it comes up and it comes back and it goes. When I had my first relationship, I wouldn't call it a relationship. It was just two teenagers just bickering for God knows how many years. And then ended up being really narcissist to you. And then you turned a bit crazy and went through a deep dark depression for a couple of years. But hey ho, let's not blame the dude. That whole time, it only just flared up on my scalp, really. But when he pissed off, basically, I was covered in it. Like, I didn't want to go out. And my mate, she was just like, you're going to be okay. You're going to be okay. And, like, literally, this was like this when I was at school. It was at its worst when I was at school. At school, I was covered in it. But I never took my blazer off in the summer. I never took my jumper off. I never took my shirt off. I never took my tights off. I didn't wear high knee socks. Nothing. I couldn't, because I was covered in it. Because, like, kids were crawling my scalp. I don't know, it's like I spoke to Manny the other night. I've had customers that I've served and they've seen my arms and they go, is that contagious? Or there was one lady that was fuming. I said, is everything okay, honey? And she was just a bit like, And then she sort of went back to her husband that was on the trolley. And was like, have you seen that? Oh my God, we're gonna catch that, aren't we? Is that pox or something? And I thought, I talk to people about it all the time. Like, I still do get quite a lot of criticism about it. Like, you get, oh, use moisturiser. Have you seen my cupboard with all the skincare, the medication I have to take? When I was at school, I think the more I used to get upset about it, the worse it got. It was quite a hard time in my life, actually. School was quite rough. I think the more I was fearing that it was going to be seen, I think the worse it got, because I was more scared of what people were going to think of it. See, the worst case scenarios, my anxiety used to come through, like, oh my God, if I look like, if I have my arms out, the parents might call and say and complain that I'm looking like this and the kids are going to catch it. Like, I get that all the time. When I was growing up, I used to have it, I used to have experiences all the time. My mum's used to be a bit funny and go, oh, it looks contagious. And it used to be one of those things that was really, it was really hard growing up with it. But now I'm like, it's there. But sometimes I do end up like really upset. It was like, there was one lady, she just blatantly come out and said it and said, is that contagious, by the way? Loud enough for everyone to here. And I was like, no, of course it's not. It's just it's a skin condition. I was born with it. She said, they're lucky they're letting you work on the tills. Can you wear longer sleeves? I wear a top underneath that shirt because the shirt fibers irritates my skin. Why should I have to hide my skin condition that I was born with and have absolutely no control over? Even with medication, it's still unpredictable. Customers are weird. Still to this day, I get people like looking at me. Like, one time I went out for a night out about a couple of years ago, and it really got to me. Went to an after party, and this girl was asking, is that eczema? Oh, did you go sunbed? Did you use moisturiser? Do you drink enough water? And I was like, you know, you get them people that think they know what they're talking about, but because they haven't seen how, they haven't been me growing up. And I just think, I said to her, what kind of expertise do you do then with skin? Because obviously I was a bit pissed, and you know, when I blur everything out when I've had a drink. She was like, I do Botox. So you're going to tell me that, right, you do Botox, you do you. That's amazing. As long as you don't keep doing it for several years on end, because it does cause damage. But if you want to glow up for a bit, fine. If you want to go for a face and try it out, fine. But the way she was like talking down on me, saying, oh, you shouldn't be taking yeast, you shouldn't be doing this. You should. Ever since I was a baby, they've been experimenting what triggers it. It's an emotional thing that triggers it. So that's where I get annoyed. This is The Selfless by Hiram. Can I try and read this? The Nias niacinamide and maracuja daily barrier support moisturizer. It's for day and night, as you can see there, so I use it morning and night. Here we are, all clean, dunking already. Anyway, my darlings, oh god, I've got some serum on my eye. Ow, let's get edited. Let's go and do some editing. Let's go and do some
down here. This is where like people go drifting at night.
Already look, there's loads of people be drifting here.
Should we check it out?
Hi guys, I fell down the rabbit hole. I went on TikTok the other night. This is what being single is.
Disgusting.
So we got one of the TikTok pickles. We just went to watch a load of drifters and we were just sitting there just for like 10 minutes watching them. It was so good. This is the Van Holten's dill pickle in hearty dill flavour. What is dill?
A herb. Want to get tissue?
I'm scared.
Drink some of the water out of it.
Apparently you've got to drink the juice.
If you didn't know what dill was, why did you get dill?
Because apparently that's the one for basic bitches.
Okay, that sounds about right.
So it looks really girthy.
I'm going to walk home.
Man, he's in the car. And she doesn't want to be filmed today, so we've got to respect that. It's a pickle. A cucumber. Then it gets turned into a pickle because it's been pickled.
Cucumbers, crunchy, sour, salty or sweet. Pickles are all sort of the same way cucumbers. They grow on fire from a cucumber bush. They're like hot temperatures and lots of wet water.
Oh, lovely. It didn't say what temperature to do this. By the way, guys, I look absolutely mashed as I always do anyway. Basically, work was a bit insane today. Look, left work with blue paint on me, soot, and all that jazz, and I was covered in sweat because it was so manic today. I can't even tell you. Are you ready to open her up? This is the curiosity that I go through in my mind. Oh, it even sounds horrible. Oh, that's a pungent whiff.
I can smell it.
That's a pungent whiff right there. It reminds me of something. Mint sauce?
It smells like tartar sauce.
Tartar sauce? It's a bit girthy.
Drink some of the juice and figure.
You can't drink the juice.
No, you have to, because you're going to get like, it's going to, just drink it. It's pickled. It's like pickled onion. Or
I can't do it with a straight face.
Disgusting. Pickle juice.
Oh, this takes me back. Hello, darkness, my old friend. Is that how it goes? I can't breathe. TikTok kept screaming at me, so I thought, okay, I'll try one.
Your video should get banned.
It's been a while.
Hurry.
Oh, he just slithered back in. Oh, it's got a mind of its own, hello.
Chop, chop.
Oh god, I'm scared. It literally looks like a poo.
That's not what you were trying to describe.
It looks in between something that I haven't received in a very long time. Oh, it looks like something we pooped out after having chat all night. Sorry guys, I do like chat. I'm not coming at people who like chat.
Oh.
I've got a bottle of water in the back in case I'm going to be sick.
Yeah, if you are, just get out. Won't take me that long, I'll get an Uber.
He'd abandon me!
No, I'll call you. Won't be around this situation.
I'm so nervous, it actually makes me want to poo.
Stop, did you say poo?
Yeah. So this one's for basic bitches.
It smells pickly.
But what, how basic bitch is this?
Well, you'll find out.
Scared.
Yeah, is it really that bad?
You know when you get that moment with a Sour Patch Kid or like one of those really super sour sweets? 1 minute you can't, like 1 second you can't control yourself and then it's nice.
So what is it?
Very vinegary.
Because it's pickle.
It looks like something I haven't seen or been involved with for a long amount of time. Oh my god, there's a butthole on it. Can you eat the butthole?
I'm not involved.
How do you approach it? You approach it with caution. Like any other reproductive organ. Do I just go Dutch and just go in?
Take a full proper bite and
try
fully try and understand what is going on now.
My eyes are watering. The consistency is like inside of a grape. That's where my little teeth have gone into. I've got very weird teeth. That's one quality about me that I like, is my teeth. Because they're different. The drifters are coming. They're vlogging, drifting their car. They're vlogging, eating a pickle. Oh god. And it's getting mushier. Wait, is this expired?
Yeah.
Don't tell me it's expired.
Over there, mate. Tissue's there.
No, you know when it gets cold in the back of your throat and it tickles.
No, I don't. No, I really don't. I don't know. Thanks. Cancelled.
Oh, honey, that part of my life's been cancelled for f***ing years.
Ear them.
I'm trying. It's just a lot. This is me you're talking to.
I don't like Dill.
Vinegary nut, bitch. Jesus. The only thing I'm concerned with, it doesn't have the expiry date on it, which is what I should have looked at. It was one of the first things I should have looked at, right? It's doing some sensations in my mouth. It's just so...
Maybe the vinegar.
Yeah, that's... I can't have too much vinegar.
I'm just mortified.
Honestly
mortified. Yeah, because... Dill and that thing.
I'm going to be in a bit of a pickle tonight, aren't I? Oh, watching Drifters while we're eating a pickle.
What about that thing where they put the fruit roll thing on it?
That made me want to be sick. But there are some things that we have, that humans have compared together, like combined is the word, right? And it's bomb. It bangs. My friend put Takis in one of these, and Takis I don't really like.
Yeah, they're a bit pungent.
A bit pungent. I don't know what to come with this. It's weird. I mean, I haven't had like a pickle in years, but it's slightly tingling my lips. Is that supposed to be normal?
Might be the vinegar.
Oh, yeah, true. And my little bite marks. TikTok was screaming at me to do this, and I was like, fine, I'll do it. This looks like a bag that you have at the hospital.
Looks like actually a catheter.
Guys, I don't know what to make of this. I mean, it's okay. It wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be. It's very strong. I would proceed with caution. All right, just sliding back into the bag. Look at that. It's just swimming. It looks like something you find at the bottom of a well. Maybe I should try the sour one. I don't want to try the spicy one because I heard the spicy one is actually quite bad.
I don't think you'll be able to handle it.
Oh, no! Got vinegar, isn't it? Got cleaning qualities in vinegar.
That's like saying, let me just rub a bit of onion and vinegar on you.
Out of the window, it works every time. Yeah, I can't eat any more of it. It's like so vinegary. I think we need to put this in the bin. Where did it drip? The more it's in here, the more I can smell it.
More. Yeah, it's inside you too. No, I meant that. Keep like your stomach.
When a guy sees me naked.
Oh god.
Just please.
Oh god.
Nice. Okay. Then we're gonna figure out what to do with this. I don't have a peg.
No. You. Stop with the wee. You are gonna move away from me. Go away, what are we doing?
Oh, we've got some really good footage. We drove around sunsets and I forgot to vlog. But we got some footage on Manny's phone, so we're gonna put some footage in now.
Closer. No time to be sober, sunshine on my shoulders.
It was 30 something today, so you're gonna have to figure the old girl. Yes, some countries are going to say grow the F up. In the UK, we're not used to this kind of heat. Working in retail when that heat, oh, it was hell. Yesterday, I didn't take you guys along with me because it was so like first day of working days. I had a list for stuff to go away with next week. You're gonna see a packing with me video. I had a little list of things to get when we go away. I didn't have a bag because I broke my suitcase when we went Pakistan. Everything was all going wrong. We went to Primark, but we didn't do a Primark haul. This was an essential Primark, so we've got to call it like a mini Primark haul. I got in there in that heat. It was hideous going down the motorway. I forced myself just park straight outside Primark and not in the mall car park, so I didn't get tempted to go in any other shops.
Willpower.
That was willpower for me, yo. So yeah, went in there. I was in there for 20 minutes. Dart in, out. Like, literally, dart in, out. And I got everything I needed. And I looked at my list. I was on the phone to my friend from work yesterday. I went, oh, I got everything on the list. And she was like, oh, brilliant. Because normally when I go in Primark, you know me, I go from north to south to east to west and Dakota and everywhere else. And I end up spending... Hello. Okay. So, first of all, we went Primark. I darted down the A13, got into the new Home Bargains, the big one, had my little essentials list, got everything on the list, nothing else, which was brilliant. Went all the way to this card shop to get a Father's Day card because I thought it was this Sunday, and I thought, oh no, because I'm doing a double on Saturday, which is today, and a double tomorrow on Sunday. And I just knew there's going to be no way I could have got to this shop would be closed. So I got it yesterday thinking it was a Father's Day, like today's you guys are watching this. No, it's not. It's next week. Look at my messy bun. I don't care. I just want it out of my face. Anyway, guys, let's show you what I got from Primark. Going to be like the most sensible haul I've ever done. Comes with a strap. So I didn't really want to have a suitcase because I knew like it'd be taking space in the car. We're going centre bucks, by the way, over them for it. Yeah, I just wanted a nice weekend bed that had lots of different pockets in it, obviously, to put my filming stuff in, to put my wiring in, to put just enough space to fit everything in, but be small enough that it's not gonna like take a load of space out of the car. I've got this black weekender bag that has this nice lovely silver zip on the front here, which I could possibly fit my laptop in. Then we've got these really cool storage things here on the side, so I thought I could put like my chargers in there, my batteries in there for my camera. It's got a few little compartments inside here, and I thought that'd be great. This was £16, a little bit steep, but for £16 it feels really good quality. Actually, it comes with a stop here, but I just thought it was really, really nice. It's not too big, it's perfect for me. Because I'm only bringing really thin material because over there, next week's going to be very, very hot. So, we've got that. Go with it because I haven't got any, at all, any cosmetic cases that's waterproof that I could... I just wanted something to stuff all in, go in there and then just use it and chuck it in as a swimming bag. I wanted to use the bag as a swimming bag as well. So, I've had like multi-uses out of it. So, we've got this £6... lovely see-through cosmetic case. Yeah, I just thought it was really nice, and it zips from the top here, and it's got this nice faux leather croc kind of design, so I thought that would be perfect. Take with me to centre parks and swimming with as well, so if it gets wet it's not a big deal, it's just gonna dry. Oh guys, in this weather this is gonna be my best friend. This was £2 and I thought this was cheap as cheeps. You guys weren't born yesterday, you know what this is. This was £2. How good is that? It's a full face gel mask if you've never seen it before. And it's got like these weird orbies in it. So I thought that would be nice. So I thought this would be lovely. Especially to have like nearly bedtime or early in the morning. And just like have it on, or like after coming home doing our sports in the day and stuff like that. It's going to be so hot next week. So I'm not looking forward to that. This gel was not made for hot weather. But that's Father's Day card. It's like handmade. I'm not going to show you that in case he accidentally sees my video. Yes, we got some super soft 120 rand cosmetic pads. So as you guys know, I've started toning now because it's summer. I just needed to take like nice small amount of them that I can just squish in the bag like that and just take with me. And I thought, for 50 pence... can you argue with that? I would use my reusable ones, but I just wanted it to be quick, easy, because it's just, we've got lots of things planned ahead, I believe. I tried to get some black Crocs, and I could not find any my size online in the shops that I liked. I like the high platform ones now. I couldn't find them in my size. I'm a size 7, but I know they come in fashion. Everyone laughed at me a year and a half ago that I now am a croc mum, and now everyone wants to wear them because King K was born. Oh, I got these for £6. These are like the dupe croc flip-flops. So I wanted to be quite easy, simple. So I've got my pink juicy trainers for sports in the day. And then like in between I've got my white Crocs, and now I have these. They look really comfortable. They might take a couple of days to break in. I should have gone out with these today, I think, in between work and just try and stretch them out a little bit. But they feel very strong. Maybe they'll probably last for a few months and then I'll chuck them. For £6, I can't argue with that. With centre parks, you want to be nice, casual, but comfortable at the same time. I knew how hot it was going to be. I bought these extra soft socks for £3 for 7 pairs. I was like,
Can't argue with that. So we've got like nice nudie pinks, beiges, khakis, all these really, really nice colours there. And I thought that'd be quite nice to go with, because some of the outfits, most of the outfits I bought, actually, even the sporting stuff, it's more like nudes and beiges. So I thought, all right, Chloe, let's try it out. Okay, so I didn't want to wear my nice prior earrings at swimming, especially because I'm known to lose things. God knows how many things are at the bottom of that St. Park's pool. That's mine. There are 6 pairs, I believe, that you mix and match. Now, £4.50, and I thought these were great. Lovely gold as well, because obviously you can tell, like, I've been wearing gold for quite a while now. So we've got these Primark cares. Yeah, so we've got these really nice ones. We've got ones with like nice little study stars. Got like the typical little diamond hoops there, nice little diamondy droplets, pearls, moon, stars, you name it. And what I love about these, you can just mix and match them. And if they fall out, if I lost one, it's not a big deal. If I lost a couple pairs in the pool, or, you know, look like some dropped when we went to the bar or whatever, it's not a big deal. Got them for £4.50, and I thought, gee, I fell in love with this when I saw this, and it was £2. So if I lose this and it goes gross by the end of the week, it's not a big deal, you know. I just wanted some little bits to layer over my like gold bits, like it's some little like cheapy bits just to like top over, and if it breaks, it's not a big deal. So I've gone for this horoscope charm. I've gone for this horoscope Scorpio medallion design star necklace. It's like a pressed coin with the Scorpio sign there, and the back of the chain is actually really long, I believe. And I thought, if I lost that, it's not a big deal, it's just £2. It's like a foundry dupe. This one is come to Centre Park for me. I don't know why, I just really like it. And then to top that off, I got anklets. So if you guys know, I've got some anklets I adore, and if I lost them, I'd be devastated. And I love wearing anklets by the pool. I love it. I love it so much. So these were £2.50, which is actually quite a steal. It comes in this really nice free set. So you got ones that are just like a singular diamond strand. Then you've got like the typical snake chain. And then down here, you've got little star and pearl droplets. Oh, wow, how cute. And then to top it off, now let's show you what I've got from Home Bargain. Again, essentials only, which I was very alrighty. So let's show you what I've got from Home Bargain. So the first thing I started off with, because you guys know how much I love this. This is the 36 pack of the Always Ultra Secure Night. Literally my favorite pads in the whole entire world. Then we've got some nail files for 60 something P. So I want to do my nails tomorrow night or early Saturday. Monday morning. I just thought that'd be nice, and I think I'm just gonna go with like a nice nude polish on my toes and my fingers, and then I'll bring it with me, so in case it goes nasty, I'll just take it off a little bit of nail varnish remover. And then in case, I love the fact you get a washing machine at Centre Parks, because when you have a swim costume on that smells of chlorine and you put it on the next day, even if it's fully dry, it doesn't feel nice. So I did want to get travel size washing detergent, and I could not find them anywhere. So we went with something even better. We went with the Dr. Beckham Magic Leaves Laundry Detergent Sheets, the effortless way to wash your laundry. And a friend of mine from work tries these, and she said, these are amazing. Like, look how thin it is. Look how thin they are. So of course I had to get the non-bio version because of my skin. I can't get bio because it does mess my skin up. £3 that was. So I was like, you're coming home with me. Next, we've got a few of these. These are the bubble tea, tropical bubble tea sheet mask in the hydrating and toning. You guys have seen me use these 100 times. I'm not even going to explain them to you, but these are the cheapest ones I could find. These are suitable for vegans. They're fantastic with sensitive skin. Take my word for it, my lovelies. Next, we got what I've been looking for weeks. Is Spot Zapper Patches. You guys weren't born yesterday. These are amazing. If you've got spots, like, because my period and stuff, like, I've been getting spots here, and like it happens at the exact same place. It irritates me so much. These are great. Pop one on your pimple, leave it alone, and leave it overnight. Leave it for as long as you physically can. And when you pull it off, it literally turns into a little tiny scab, like as though it has drawn out all the oil out of the pore. It's amazing. Then we went with the Etonite Beauty Perfect 6 pair under eye patches in the vitamin C version. Now, the other one was more like getting rid of wrinkles and stuff, where this one's more like the hydrating, getting rid of puffiness, the reduced puffiness and dark circles, which is what I want. 6 pairs for £1. Was really decent. Then I've got a little treat for myself if we're gonna have a bath there or a bath before we leave. This is, oh, so glad I got this, and it's £2. This is so much bar salt here. We've got the bubble tea matcha bubble tea bar salts in the hydrating and refreshing. Now the matcha one's lovely. If you like matcha tea and you've got very sensitive skin, this is a really nice one. It says, with all the goodness of antitoxin rich matcha, the nourishing bar salts are the ideal way to relax and restore after a long day. Soothes tired muscles. Then we've got a few of these. Now you know how much if I see these I buy the whole lot of them because these are becoming extremely rare. So I bought a few of these because these are so super rare. This Nair Sensitive Cream leg and body hair remover is the best one you can ever use. We've got more of the hair and scalp conditioner. This one is really nice. It's from a brand called Medipure. And if you've got really bad psoriasis, especially when you have the outbreaks on your head, this stuff is really nice. We just got these little tweezers here. Oh, hello, Canon. Yeah. Don't think you can see them, but we've just got some tweezers just to take with us in case I lose mine. So we went with the Calypso Sunburn Relief. This is the brand Calypso. We bought this last year and it was so good. I had to buy it again and it was less than £2. Then we went with Hawaiian Tropic Luminosity. I can't read. You guys know I have difficulty reading. So this is SPF 50+. I just heard some people told me if someone's got psoriasis and sensitive skin, people are telling me that this is actually quite all right stuff. We got the Colab a dry shampoo in the candy fragrance, amazing oil absorption without white residue. Now this stuff I really like. It's normally £5 a can, but in home bargains it's £1.99. I still am messed up with that Mandela effect because I swear the brand used to be called Baltiste, now it's called Batiste. That doesn't sound right to me. So that's all my haul today. I hope you guys enjoyed this week's vlog. I can't wait to show you guys what I packed for Centre Parks video, the whole entire week vlog. And then you've got a Temu haul coming up. You've got a big Poundland haul coming up, let me tell you. And we did lots of fun things this week. Anyway, guys, if you guys enjoyed that, please make sure you give me a big fat thumbs up. Also, my lovelies, do not forget to subscribe to my channel right down there. Press on that bell so you know when I next do a video. This will make sure you get notified for when I upload new videos. And also, make sure you check out my community page often. I always update you guys on behind the scenes and give you voting polls for what you kind of content you want in the future. I'm gonna love you guys. I'm gonna leave you. And I'm gonna see you guys in the next video. Bye!